take full advantage of Slick and its powerful context tagging engine, it is best to have a workspace and accompanying project file. Once you have created these and added files to them, Slickit can create a tag file for you. For this example, we will be using C++ code. First, go to Project New. Expand the C++ node and select GNU C++. If you're using anything other than Visual Studio, this is a pretty good starting point. If you are using Visual Studio, you can go to Project, Open Workspace, and open the solution directly. Fill in the project name. For project type, choose whichever one applies to your situation. We're going to choose Application for this example. Select Empty Project for application type. We'll be adding some files later. For build system, we have three choices. The first is to build without a makefile. This means that Slickit will use its own build system to manage your builds. The second is to use a user-maintained makefile or custom build command. If you already have a makefile or a custom script you run for your builds, you want this option. The third option is to build with a makefile, but have Slickit generate and maintain it for you. So you'll still have a makefile, but Slickit will use the information in the project to generate and maintain it. When we hit Finish, we get a summary dialog that reiterates what we're creating, and we'll go ahead and click OK. Now we're presented with the Project Properties dialog. If you're just starting out in Slickit, generally you want to add a tree of files. So we'll click Add Tree. Here we can include certain file specs and exclude certain file specs. For a C++ project, we probably want to include the files that are here already. We also have exclude file specs, which take an ant file spec. This is useful if you have source files that are generated under your object directories that you do not want to tag. Finally, we have three checkboxes. Recursive is pretty obvious, and if you're setting up a first workspace and you don't want to split it up into subprojects, you probably want this on. Create subfolders will affect how this looks in the project tool window. Finally, we have add as wildcard. This is good to use if everybody on your team isn't using Slickit and you don't want to have to manually add new files to your project when you update from version control and there are new files. This way Slickit will find them. We click OK and Slickit goes out and finds the files and adds them to the project. As soon as we click OK, Slickit starts tagging all the files in the project in the background. If you need to add more files, just go to Project, Properties, and click on the Files tab. Download your free trial today. Go to www.slickit.com/trial.